internet? Do we really have to argue every time there's a new M1-based computer? I don't think so, but you know who I blame? Apple. You see, Apple comes out with a new M1, and rather than showing off real numbers and real benchmarks, they just break out these meaningless bars showing it's bigger than AMD, Intel, and Nvidia. For example, here is the performance of the M1 Ultra against a 16-core Core i9-12900K. Yes, Intel's 12th gen CPU and currently arguably the best there is on PC. If you're wondering what this chart means, we can't tell you that because I don't know. It looks like the M1 Ultra is maybe 25%, maybe 30% faster than that 12th gen Alder Lake, but I don't really know. The one thing they are arguing definitely is we give you way more performance for way less power. I don't think anybody's gonna disagree on that. And here's another one. This is the M1 Ultra, slightly faster than the mighty GeForce RTX 3090. And more importantly for Apple, 200 watts less. But you're probably wondering, like me, how are you measuring what's faster? How can you say it's faster if you're not telling me what you're measuring? And then there's this montage.
The CPU performance on Mac Studio with M1 Ultra is up to 3.8 times faster than the fastest 27-inch iMac.
In what?
And it's up to 90% faster than Mac Pro with 16 cores.
How? In what?
And graphics performance on Mac Studio with M1 Ultra just crushes 27-inch iMac. It's up to a remarkable 4.5 times faster. Mac Studio is up to 80% faster.
In what? In what? I know you're thinking I'm just being a hater, but there's actually some really good data that Apple could have talked about. For example, they are saying the new M1 Ultra in the Mac Studio will outperform the current 28-core Xeon Mac Pro Tower with the fancy Afterburner custom card in it doing ProRes transcodes. Yes, a little tiny box outperforming the great big overpriced Mac Pro with a 28-core Xeon and Afterburner card. I don't know about you, but that's really impressive. And if you're gonna do video work, this should blow your socks off. There's actually more information in the Apple press release than the entire presentation that just simply said it's better. And the thing is, I actually have expectations that the new M1 Ultra will actually give the best the PC has a good run for the money. May not be faster, but it's gonna be a fun race. For example, just the other day, someone leaked the scores for an M1 Ultra in Geekbench 5. And since we know the M1 Ultra is basically two M1 Max chips glued together with a high-speed interconnect, it's looking pretty much like 2x that performance, plus a little bit for the thermal headroom. That M1 Ultra in Geekbench multi-core, basically about 24,000 and some change, compared to an Alder Lake 12900K that I tested at about 18,500 and some change. So you're basically looking at maybe 25% more performance, which is what you should expect for 20 cores versus 16 cores. Win on Apple there, probably. In single threaded though, it's gonna get interesting because that M1 Ultra leak score, again, we don't know if it's accurate, but it looks very similar to what we saw out of an M1 Max. 1793 single-threaded Geekbench, a 12900K, 2001. So the Core i9 will actually outperform that M1 Studio in lightly threaded tasks. We don't have any other leaked numbers for the M1 Ultra, but since we're going to assume it's two M1 Maxes, we can sort of guess by taking Cinebench R23 numbers for an M1 Max and doubling it, giving it a little bit more headroom for the thermals. So I'm seeing 12,381 for the M1 Max. Double that, give it a little bit more. Say 25,000, 26,000. 27 if we're generous for the M1 Ultra and Cinebench R23. 16-core, Core i9-12900K, 27,275. So it might be very close in multi-threaded performance between the M1 Ultra and the 12900K. And when we get to Cinebench R23 using single-threaded, again, it is simply an M1, M1 Max, M1 Pro, M1 Ultra. The scores have not changed. Maybe we'll get a little more for the thermals. I don't think we're going to get quite as much, but you're looking at about 1,531. And when you're looking at Core i9-12900K, 1,984. That's a clear win for the PC. So when we get to the end and finally see real benchmarks of the M1 Ultra, I fully expect to be impressed. So if I know it, and you know it, and they know it, why won't you, Apple, just provide the meaningful benchmarks today so we can stop all the arguing for now?